Hi, I'm Al, and this is a video.
Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to another discussion. As you guys know, I like having these, like, open dialogues occasionally. Whenever something happens in the community or something that I feel like needs to be discussed. And one of those things just happened, and I wanted to talk about that. So, Vibrant and the mod team recently had a survey over on Twitter, over on Discord, all of those places where they ask the community whether or not layout style levels should be rated. And the reason this was brought up was because of a certain little level named Bliss made by Marwek and Burgos, two very, very talented creators, right? And Vipern specifically asked, about 7,000 people answered the survey, and he asked, should layout style levels be rated? And a very large majority, it seemed like, said yes to this, with around 30% of the community saying no or I don't care. And I wanted to have a little bit of a discussion about whether or not stuff like this should be rated. What you're seeing play on screen right now is Bliss by Burgos and Marwek, as it has been rated and put on Burgos' account. And I wanted to have a little bit of, like, a back and forth between you guys and myself. So basically what they mean by layout style is not stuff like Dear Nostalgias, where it's just like a 1.0 style level. It's more or less just an effect level that brings an idea or just brings vibrancy and color and effects into a level. But the block design is more of that resembling a 1.0 level. It uses the base blocks and not really much more than that, and it puts all of the efforts into the effects and the colors, basically. And I think this is a little bit of a unique discussion to be had, because technically speaking, Vipern and the mod team doesn't really have any say in whether or not these levels would be rated. It is going to be 100% up to RobTop regardless whether or not it gets rated. But I think it's a cool little discussion to have, right? Because I feel like there's two sides to the coin on this one. I feel like on one end, it means that we could see a lot of really, like, fun, cool levels. Because what I know a few people have said is that they don't mind as long as the level's fun. And Bliss, as an example, is a very fun level. It's a really, really good. But we also are going to see people that are going to be like, oh, but this level's rated. Why is that level not rated? And there's going to be like a huge clash between that. And I hate using this word. I hate using the word that I'm about to use. But I feel like that side of the coin will mostly come from people who are kind of elitist towards stuff like this. People who are going to be hounding for certain levels to be rated, especially extremes that have taken a long time to release that haven't been rated yet. I can name a couple. I've seen a lot of people in my streams, for instance, they say, oh, why is not Promethean rated yet? Or why is this level not rated yet? Or that level rated yet? Promethean is a very big example of it because it was recently released after Rico spent like 120,000 times verifying it or something. Something crazy like that. I think it is going to have, like, not really a divide. I feel like most people won't really mind these levels be rated because they look good. We've seen a lot of these levels get rated before. It shouldn't really matter too much, but I feel like people are going to try and weaponize it, saying that, oh, but this level is rated. Why can't this level be rated? Because we already see that. That's already an ongoing issue. You already see people be like, oh, but EXO is rated. Conical Depression is rated. That's just Karma L privilege, let's be real. I feel like that's a terrible argument to make. That's just Karma L privilege. As much as people hate to recognize the fact that that's a thing, certain creators will have an easier time getting their levels rated. Sonic Wave of Rebirth got epic. It's 5 years old. But that's besides the point. I digress. I feel like people are going to weaponize it, but stuff like, oh, but Bliss is rated. It has no block design. Why can't this level be rated as well? And while it's a very minor issue, it's always the very prominent, loudmouth people, especially over on Twitter, who are gonna be very aggressive towards that. And I feel like it's going to create a slightly bigger divide when it comes to, like, people who are agreeing and disagreeing on what should be rated, and people are going to just amplify the aggressive nature of making levels rated. I remember very vividly the Balengu Vortex crusades, almost, about getting Balengu Vortex rated, because everyone was like, oh, it's just better Bowser Vortex, even though it's like 4 years newer, the Bowser Vortex. And it's like, in one way or another, I understand it. I understand why, because people don't like it when their work and efforts aren't being valued or aren't being appreciated. So in a sense, I do understand why people want these levels to be rated. But at the same time, I feel like people just have to recognize that Rob Top just rates whatever the hell he wants. He just rates whatever he feels like. And on one end, yeah, sure, it's weird, but like, can you really blame him? If Rob doesn't like a level but likes another level that you think the opposite of, you can't really change that, right? But either way, I do still think that is going to create more aggressiveness towards this kind of stuff on Twitter, especially. You don't see it much anywhere else, I feel like. You do see it in the comments of levels, like, oh, rate this, rate that, yada, yada, yada. But what do you guys think about the idea of layouts being rated? Because I don't think they're layouts. Every time a layout is brought up into the discussion of, hey, can we rate this layout? People are always like, oh, but layouts like Isle of Null is rated, right? And it's like, Isle of Null is not a layout. I refuse to recognize Isle of Null as a layout. That is an effect level that embraces the idea of simplicity and block design to amplify the effects made in the level to make it look absolutely stunning. And I will stand by that. I think that is 100% the case. Isle of Null is an absolute masterclass of a level just because of that. It's not a layout, it's an effect level. I think the same goes for Bliss. I think Bliss is not really much of a layout. It's more of just an effect level that embraces the colors and the effects that it makes and just says, fuck it, I'm gonna make simple block designs just to like put all of my effort into the effect and design. It's not epic rated. So it's not like Raul was like, oh yeah, that's a perfect level. Raul was like, yeah, that's a good level. I'm gonna give it featured, which it is, it's a good level. But I wanna know what you guys think. Where do you guys draw the line between layout and non-layout? And what do you guys think about layout style levels in quotation marks? Because I think personally that layouts add nothing. It's just blocks, it's just gameplay, nothing else. Do you think that there should be something as closely related to layout style as possible? And where do you guys think the line should be drawn on where it should be rated or not? I personally think once you can start looking at a layout and say, wow, that looks good, that's where the line is drawn. That is not anymore a layout, that is a good full-on level, but it uses 1.0 style blocks, which is fine. I think that's okay. I don't mind that, personally. But I want to hear what you guys have to say. I had a little bit of an open dialogue. I just spoke my mind a little bit. What do you guys think? I would love to hear. I'll be reading your comments. Either way, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys around. Take care. Love you all. Stay hydrated. Stay healthy. Eat your greens. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I'll talk to you guys later. Peace out, everyone.